English senior, August 2016. Mr. Speaker, sir, at the outset, I thank the honorable members for the constructive suggestions they have made in the course of the debate. I think you will agree that the debate was mainly concentrated on famine. Of course, we all agree that we are passing through a very difficult period and the people are suffering a lot. Now we have to see how we can give relief to the people in dealing with this problem. I would like to say this. We were doing our best to save the people of this state by giving relief to them. But in spite of that, it has been said that we have made difference between region and unregion. In this connection, I may tell the House that as far as this matter is concerned, our conscience is quite clear. As Finance Minister, I am aware of the expenditure which was sanctioned for the purpose of famine relief. Those who think that we have not gone far to give more relief have not understood the magnitude of the problem and the resources available to the government to meet famine conditions. Honorable members think that we have got enough resources to meet the problem of this size. It is not true. That is why the Chief Minister told the House yesterday that this was an unprecedented famine. It is not as if we are going through normal times. We are passing through abnormal times. There was drought during the last 6 years. To that extent, the resources of the government have been affected. That was why the Chief Minister said that the central government must come to the aid of this state. In the coming year, I hope that we will have normal condition so that the people may get some relief. It is with that hope that the government have provided for 17 lakhs of rupees for famine relief. Honorable members need not think that this is the only amount that is available for famine relief. I would like to point out that there are many other sources from which adjustments can be made. If there is distress in a particular area, we can divert money to that area. If any area is affected again by drought conditions, we will face it with determination, and I am sure that I will have the cooperation of the House in providing relief to the affected people. We are talking of famine. At the same time, we have also to face the problem of unemployment and the low purchasing power among the people. In my opinion, this is due to the fact that the majority of our people are engaged in agriculture and agriculture depends upon a fair monsoon. If there is failure of monsoon, to that extent, production goes down. So, when there has been failure of monsoon for 6 years, the purchasing power of the people goes down. There is nothing surprising about it. The leader of the opposition seems to think that if we give 70% of the produce to the tenant, it will lead to increased production. But I would like to point out that we are mostly a state of fees and properties. In spite of that, production is going down. As a matter of fact, production has gone down throughout the country. If that is so, it is due to failure of rains. Further, it must be remembered that the land holding are small and the peasants do not have sufficient capital to invest in agriculture. We must improve the economic condition of the peasants. Letter from Varadhanan Company, Tirupur to Messrs. Ramanujam and Company, Chennai. Dear Sars,
We thank you very much for your letter of the 3rd instant in this connection. We would like to inform you that we have received just now the 4 consignments of the class articles sent by you by rail. We are glad to inform you that we are very much pleased with the quality of the goods supplied to us. At the same time, we regret to inform you that one of these consignments have been damaged so much that they have become useless. But we wish to tell you that the damage had not been due to any mistake on your part. It is clear to us that the damage has occurred during transit by rail. We have seen that the railway authorities have not taken sufficient care in handling the goods. It seems to us that some heavy goods were placed above this consignment. As a result, the goods have been damaged. We have reported the matter to the railway authorities. We enclose a copy of our letter of complaint lodged with the railway authorities so that you may pursue the matter with them and claim damages. Apart from that, according to the terms and conditions of the contract of sale entered into by us, we shall be glad if you make necessary arrangements to send goods to replace the damaged articles. Yours faithfully.